Let's be honest, nuclear power is a bit scary. We hear the word nuclear and think of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the Cold War, and mutually assured destruction. But it wasn't always this way. In the 1950s, nuclear power was our ticket to an idyllic future, with magazines predicting a reactor in every home, and even Walt Disney celebrating our friend the atom. Of course, that utopia never materialized. And today, memories of Fukushima, Chernobyl, and Three Mile Island leave many of us feeling uneasy. Some countries have decided to phase out nuclear power, while their neighbors have plans to expand it. So, is it dangerous and outdated, or is it still the future of energy? Although it was first developed to build the bombs that ended World War II, today nuclear power is mostly used to generate electricity, making up about 10% of the world's output. But the raw materials like uranium and plutonium aren't batteries you can just plug into. In fact, a nuclear power plant works in much the same way as a coal or gas-fired one, by heating water into super hot steam, which drives turbines rigged up to create an electrical current. The difference is the way heat is created, through a process called fission, meaning the splitting of atoms. Inside a plant's reactor, subatomic particles called neutrons are fired at pellets of uranium held in long metal tubes. This causes the uranium atoms to split into different, lighter ones, and release more neutrons, which split more uranium, and so on, in a chain reaction. Every split also releases energy in the form of heat, which is used to boil the water. The big advantage of this process over burning fossil fuels is that it doesn't give off any greenhouse gases. Great news for the climate. The downside is that instead of carbon dioxide, it leaves behind radioactive waste that's harmful to people in high doses and has to be sealed away for thousands of years. Plus, old nuclear plants are often vulnerable to climate change, increasing sea levels, storms, and wildfires, making their safety more fragile. If something goes wrong and an overheated reactor gets damaged, radiation can escape, poisoning people and the environment. Such incidents are rare, but they do happen. Inevitably then, nuclear power always carries a risk factor, but atomic advocates argue that we tend to overestimate its dangers while underestimating those of fossil fuels. Perhaps because images of mushroom clouds are seared into our collective memory and are easier to imagine than the slow, invisible choking of our lungs and planet, nuclear power hits people at gut level and creates political heat. With one minority dead set against it, another all in favor, and everyone else spread out in nervous confusion somewhere in between. But the biggest headache for nuclear power might not be the image problem or even the health hazards, but something far more mundane: the cost. Plants are hugely expensive to construct, frequently running over budget and behind schedule. So even with government support, few firms want to get involved. And while construction drags on, wind and solar power get cheaper, and batteries get better at storing electricity for cloudy, windless days, meaning renewables account for a growing share of our clean energy. Altogether, it would seem the atomic age is unlikely to last the rest of this century. But fission isn't the only source of nuclear power. Another is fusion, forcing lighter atoms together to make heavier ones. This is what powers our sun, and scientists are getting close to recreating it on Earth. To effectively create a miniature star, deuterium and tritium atoms are heated into plasma, an electrified gas, at temperatures over 100 million degrees Celsius, where they form helium and give off even more heat. Because something that hot would melt anything it touches, the plasma has to be suspended in midair using powerful magnets or lasers. As you can imagine, creating these conditions takes a lot of power, but experiments are nearing ignition, the point of getting more energy out than goes in. When we can sustain that, nuclear fusion will be in business. Fusion has other advantages too. It doesn't leave radioactive waste, and the fuel is surprisingly accessible. Deuterium can be found in seawater, and tritium can be made from lithium, like the battery in your laptop. The snag is, it's unclear how soon it'll be viable. Some companies claim they'll be providing power in the 2030s, but more cautious commentators, who don't need to attract investors, say fusion reactors won't be on the grid until the second half of this century. Too late to help us meet our carbon emissions targets. By now, we've been friends with the atom long enough to know its flaws. Its destructive rages, its toxic leftovers, its constant demands for care and respect. But despite how large these loom in our imaginations, nuclear power still has much to offer. Maintaining our old reactors and improving their safety are good investments while we transition away from fossil fuels, or until the old murky past of fission gives way to the new clear future of fusion.